The wonderful message here is that he is the God who is forever. Abraham planted a tamarisk tree in Beersheba and called there on the name of the Lord, the everlasting God. Abraham's received from God provision for all his earthly life. He receives peace with Abimelech and also with the rather menacing Phicol, the general of his army, no longer a threat to his life. And he also receives and secures the rights to a well, to the water that will mean life and a future in a dry land. But God also here gives a fresh provision for his spiritual walk, doesn't he? And a new revelation of himself as the everlasting God, the forever God. God's already revealed himself to Abraham by a number of names, hasn't he? Chapter 14, he was El Elyon, God Most High, above all earthly lords, so that if you have his protection, no other is needed. Chapter 17, he called him El Shaddai, the all-sufficient one who can do everything that he promises. Chapter 16, remember, in the desert he revealed himself as El Rui, the seeing one who sees all his folly, who sees all his failure, but still restores him and prospers him. And now Abraham discovers that this God is also El Olam, the forever God, the everlasting God, whose powerful presence with him is forever, not just fleeting, whose pattern of working peace with his enemies is forever, it's not just occasional, and his provision for his servant is forever. Even though, as verse 34 reminds us, Abraham is still just a sojourner. He's just passing through in life. But this wonderful new revelation is given to him. And it looks as though Abraham marked this revelation by planting this tamarisk tree, a long-living tree, an evergreen tree, by this well of water. And surely that's an expression of trust in the God who is the forever God. Reminds us, doesn't it, of the pictures that the Bible so often uses of those who truly know and delight in the covenant God. Think of Psalm 1. Blessed is the man whose delight is in the instruction of the Lord. He is like a tree planted by streams of water, fruitful always, not withering, secure in all that he does. He prospers. And here, it says of Abraham saying, yes, Lord, I believe you when you say that you are the forever God. That what I've seen you do in the past, that what I've seen you do now, today, you'll keep on doing in the future and forever. That I can trust you to be the permanent provider for me and for all my needs on earth, just as this well will permanently provide for this tree and keep it alive. So I can put down roots in this place that you've given me, despite all these pagan kings, despite the armies, despite all the uncertainties, the things that otherwise might make me fear, because I trust in the permanence of your provision for me, because you are my God forever. Do you think that was a wonderful thing for Abraham to know then? That the God who had done all these things in his life, who promised all of this for him, was the forever God, was the unchanging God, the everlasting God? Because all his life he was just a sojourner, wasn't he? It's there in verse 34 to remind us at the end. And we are too. And doesn't it make a difference to you to know that, that your God is your permanent provider forever? You see, on the one hand, that means that you can accept that you are but a sojourner. You're just fragile. You're finite. And we're often feeble, aren't we? We're passing through this life. We're ever drawing nearer to the twilight days of this life, like the grass that withers and fades, that soon will be gone. And yet, on the other hand, at the same time, you're like Abraham's tree, evergreen. You're rooted. You're permanent. You're planted by an abundant source of life-giving water, belonging forever to the forever God, to the one who's promised to be your provider, whatever the future holds, and to be God to you forever, because you also are Abraham's seed. You're an heir, according to this same promise. That's something that means everything to me. Because it means however uncertain in this world I might be, I can entrust my future to him. I can put down roots in eternity with the everlasting God because he forever is my God. And I can live in the present without paralysis, without worry, because he's told me he will provide everything I need, and I can trust him forever on that. He did it yesterday. He does it today. And he says he'll do it forever. You can trust in the word of a God who's forever.